Good day. So we are going to discuss today regarding the module. Since remember that we already watched the previous video that summarizes the entirety or the entirely the coverage of the statistics, no, for technology. So with this course, we are going to focus also on the module provided by our university and proceeding to page one rather, no? You will see the course title here, and then that is with the subject code STAT, with course title Statistics for Technology. On page two, you are provided with the vision mission of our university, wherein the vision is, which is CCSPC, which is ZPPSU now, Zamboanga Peninsula Polytechnic State University, which serve as the leading provider of globally competitive human resources, with the mission provide effective and efficient services through advanced technological studies and researches for the empowerment of nation's human resources. Institutional outcomes to be students to be globally competitive, to provide globally competitive graduates who can perform advanced technological competencies in their field of specialization. More importantly, the core values also, love of God, social responsibility, commitment, dedication to the service, and accountability. Okay, so with the introduction, welcome to Zamboanga City State Polytechnic College. That was the previous name of our university, and now we call this as Zamboanga Peninsula Polytechnic State University, known to be as ZPPSU, the premier higher education institution, or the premier higher education institution in Zamboanga Peninsula, one of the centers of development in teacher education institutions in the country, and an ISO accredited institution as recognized by the Commission on Higher Education. It is our pride and honor that you chose ZPPSU as your school of choice. Okay, so you can read this one and understand for page two. Continuing, if you can observe on the last for the last on the last paragraph of page two, for this semester your class in Statistics for Technology focuses on the concepts and skills development of statistics. It attempts to provide general background and principles needed in the collection, organization, analysis, and interpretation of data. This is the very purpose of statistics subject, no? That it will attempt us to provide the general background and principles, no? In the collection of the data, organize it, analyze, and interpret. Okay? Furthermore, it develops the students' deeper critical and analytical thinking as they apply knowledge in mathematics and other allied subjects. Exercises and assessment of learning activities are provided to test your comprehension and apply the concepts that you have learned from this module. After accomplishing all modules, you are expected to, number one, develop in the students' skills in performing the operations and describing data on measure of central tendency and variability, statistical inference, analysis of variance, and enumeration data, linear regression, and correlation. So remember of this, no? Na-discuss na to sa video, yung central tendency and variability. Remember, central tendency, ano-ano yung composed doon sa video. Meron tayo yung average or the arithmetic mean, central tendency, mean, median, and mode. Okay? And then for the variability, ano tong variability? We call this, ito ba yung tinutukoy yung measure of dispersion? Okay? And then statistical inference, ito, no? Enumeration of data, linear regression correlation, no? Na-discuss din doon. Number two, demonstrate skill in solving problems involving measure of central tendency. Okay? Solving problem para compute yung central tendency and variability, statistical inference, analysis of variance, and enumeration data, linear regression and correlation. Develop in the student's appreciation of the course content as an essential tool in solving problems. Okay, you are also taught on how to use this module. Okay, it must be taken note that this is a self-study module, particularly designed to help you study with little or no intervention from your teacher. No, please follow very carefully with the instructions on how to use this module so you can fully benefit from it. The lessons on this module are logically organized. Every lesson is connected to the next and necessary for a better understanding of the next topic. Hence, please do not skip even a single page. Otherwise, may consequence yan. Pag may na-skip kayong page, mamimiss nyo, no? Some of the topics. Read every page of this module and do every task that is asked of you, which will form part of your activity to be submitted online. Read the table of contents. Okay, read the table of contents so that you will have a good grasp, no, of the entire course, no. Makukuha nyo yung magandang absorption ng knowledge sa entire of this module. Having an overview on the table of contents of what you are about to study will help you see the interrelationships of the concepts or knowledge that you are about to learn. Every lesson or unit begins with the learning objectives. The objectives are the target skills or knowledge that you must be able to gain or perform after studying the entire lesson or unit. You are also to take the post-test, okay? Ano ibig sabihin ng post? That is after, no? Take the after test activity or practice exercise given at the end of the lesson or unit. Do this only when you have thoroughly read the entire lesson or unit. When answering every activity, test, or exercise, please answer them honestly without looking at the answer key. Yes, no? You have to be honest in answering the activity, test, or exercise, that because that will only test your comprehension, kung naintindihan ninyo ba ang binasa ninyo, no? So kung kukopyahin nyo lang at i-answer doon sa activity ninyo without comprehension, copy paste lang, so it will not help you actually. Ibig sabihin, niloloko nyo lang sarili ninyo. Okay? So, dapat read and understand, comprehend it well before answering the post-test. The answer key is given to you for you to check your own progress and monitor your own understanding of the lesson. Definitely, you are provided with the module. Basahin ninyo, intindihin ninyo, and take the post-test, yun ang magsasabi kung okay na ba yung nabasa ninyo. Okay, the knowledge you will gain depends on how much effort and honesty you put into your work. No? Please pay attention to the study schedule that is reflected on page 4. Okay, which will guide you and make sure that you don't lag behind. Lag means what? You will not fall behind, no? In the progress of reading, no? Fall behind. Lag means fall. Lagging behind, falling behind will result to cramming. No, cramming yung lagging behind, when you fall behind, kung magdi-delay kayo sa ating topic na i-cover, magka-cramming na kayo, no? Ibig sabihin, nagmamadali sa pag-aaral kung saan magre-resulta ng kulang ng pagkakaintindi sa lesson, no? And eventually affects your understanding, ito na nga, no, of the lesson. Know what it takes to pass the course. Please refer to the evaluation and grading system on page 6. So, if you encounter difficult words which are not found in the glossary page of this module, take some time to locate the meaning of this word in dictionary. No? Always have the attitude pagka nag-aaral kayo, pag there are some words or terms na hindi nyo naiintindihan, takbo agad sa dictionary, andyan lang naman si Google. Wag nyong gaya ng sinabi ko to, aside from skipping the page, do not also skip of the terms that you don't understand. Otherwise, mababa yung comprehension or pagkakaintindi ninyo ng lesson, no? You will fully understand your lesson if you exert extra effort in understanding it. There is no... So, when you study or when you read, put an extra effort on that, no? To understand it. Okay? Otherwise, mahirapan kayo. Problema talaga, no? Like I said, mag-skip ka man ng konti, problema na yon, no? There is no room for laziness and complacency, no? Wala nang katamaran dito at saka yung pagiging complacent, no? Yung relax lang, no? College students na kayo, sabi dito, college students are expected to be independent learners. Continuing, if there is anything in the lesson which you need clarifications, do not hesitate to contact your instructor or professor at the appropriate time. So when we talk about appropriate time, dapat yung oras nyo lang sa class, no? During class hours lang, because it must be understood na hindi lang sa inyo yung klase ko, meron din akong other classes, no? From 7:30 to 5:30. Every day yan, Monday to Friday. So, you have to address your concern on appropriate time sa GC during class hours, no? Beyond class hours will be optional na lang pag bakante ako. Usually, nag-answer ako pag gabi because wala nang klase, no? But most of the time, I can only address this issue during class hours, or Saturday, Sunday may be an option. You will be evaluated by your instructor or professor to check how much knowledge and skills you have gained. The result of this evaluation will form a big chunk of your grade, no? So please do well and do not waste time. Lastly, you are the learner, hence you do the module on your own. Okay? Your family members and friends at home will just support you, but the activities must be done by you. As a ZPP SUans, you must always be guided by the core values, love of God, social responsibility, commitment, and dedication to the service and accountability. Moving onwards, so suggested study schedule, ito yung timeline, no? So, module 1, unit 1, we will be discussing first ito, the brief history, okay? And for the first week, we will allot 1 week only for unit 1. So, we will be talking about ito, no? Statistics. We will have the intro to get... Then together, development, independently, and understanding. Ito yung activities na iko-comply ninyo. Okay? So let's talk about this first for the first week. So let's go doon tayo sa unit 1. So So before we start with the unit 1, I would like also to discuss with the evaluation. Okay, with the module already stated, to pass this course, you must read all course readings and answer all exercises, all and activities. Answer the print-based discussion activities. Okay, submit the specified activities, submit the final project or portfolio. You will notice that sa evaluation, this will carry 50% of the semestral grade. And do the midterm and finals. Evaluative assessment activities. This will compose quizzes and examination. Okay. That is the here, no? Sa grading system natin. Submission or portfolio will be 50%. Learning outcome validation and summative assessment, no? So, dito, gaya ng sinabi ko sa learning outcome validation, you will be having the oral participation or oral recitation, the assignments and projects. Then summative assessment also. These are the quizzes, midterm exam, and final term exam. 20 and 30% respectively. A total of 100. Passing mark, like I said, 70%. And also no INC as much as possible. INC will only be given beyond human control. But and make sure as much as possible walang INC. Okay, so punta na tayo sa introduction ng statistics sa unit 1. So let's discuss now unit 1, the brief history of statistics, intended learning outcomes. After studying this module, you are expected to define what is statistics, trace the history of statistics. Okay, history tayo. Name the prominent proponents of statistics and integrate values to real life. Let's do the intro. Statistics is a branch of mathematics that deals with the scientific collection, organization, and presentation, analysis, and interpretation of numerical data in order to obtain useful and meaningful information. In simple form, statistics have been used since the beginning of the civilization when symbols were utilized, no? Where symbols were utilized to represent numbers of people, objects, animals, and others on the walls of the caves, labs, sticks, and stones, etc. So you notice, no, may mapapansin ninyo, that is sa early civilization natin, meron ng ginagamit na statistics by using symbols. No, makikita ninyo sa mga caves, may mga symbols na nakikita doon kung saan ito yung parang indicator sa kanila, ano yung mga data na meron sila to utilize it at a later kung pag-aaralan nila kung ano yung mga importance sa mga nag-gather nilang data. Okay? So, you notice before 3000 BC, the Babylonians used small clay tablets to record tabulations of agricultural yields and commodities bartered or sold. So when we talk about bartered, this is an exchange of goods, okay, without using the money, no? Without using money. Okay, the Egyptians analyzed the population and material or wealth of their country before building the pyramids, no? So before building the pyramids dati, okay, before building the pyramids, inanalyze na nila kung ilang tao ang kailangan at anong yung materials na available sa lugar nila, no? So doon no may prime may primarily ina-apply na nila yung statistics. Also, censuses were made by the Israelites. So when we talk about censuses, this is these are records, no? They make a record. This is the general, this is used for general assessment of the population, no? Mga census, no? Tulad ng ginagawa ng PSA na yun, ng PSA, no? Philippine Statistics Authority, gumagawa sila ng census so that out of the population, mayroon silang pwede nilang gawing some assessment and come up with an interpretation or study kung anong dapat gawin sa population. Numerical records in China existed before 2000 BC. Okay, numerical records sa China, meron din, no? The ancient Greeks held census to be used as basis for taxation as early as 594 BC. Okay? Sa Roman Empire naman, the Roman Empire was the first government to gather extensive data about its population, area, and wealth, no? So ibig sabihin, meron na silang data about sa meron silang data ng population ng lugar and an ilan yung area at ano yung mga available resources or wealth, no? So doon nagagamit na nila partially yung statistics. So meaning noong una pa ay meron na silang alam about the principles of statistics. Pero hindi pa nabuo yung pangalang statistics. Makikita nyo sa history mamaya. Okay? So, itong censuses pala dito were made by the Israelites or the Jews. No? During the Bible times, no? Kung mapapansin ninyo, during the Bible times, they already recorded Jacob's family members. Example, no? Yung Jacob's family member. Jacob's family members who went to Egypt, no? So they already gathered the data kung ilang family members ni Jacob na pumunta sa Egypt. So these are examples of utilizing statistics. So moving onwards, during the Middle Ages in Europe, few comprehensive censuses were made, no? Sa Europe, no? Few only. So makikita ninyo yung development sa Europe. Later on, yung mga ilang mga prominent statistician na may contribution sa statistics. No? The development of statistics in Europe was strongly motivated by the need to make sense of the large amount of data collected by population surveys in the emerging nation states. No? Dito nakikita ninyo on the previous development sa Europe, gaano kahalaga yung statistics sa kanila. In England, William the Conqueror required a compilation of information on population and resources. In the Philippines also, no? Crude statistics and several estimates were done in 1572 when Legazpi conquered the island. No, by history, when we talk about before what the history of statistics in the Philippines made, crude statistics, when you talk about crude, this is only pag sinabing crude statistics, they only made the records and documentations in their explorations, conquests, and administrative activities. Crude lang, no? Ibig sabihin, partial lang ng statistics ang ginamit ni during the time ni Legazpi when he was able to secure in 1572 yung sa Manila na to, no? So by history, remember, sa history kasi, yung expedition ni Miguel Lopez de Legazpi, yung expedition niya was started in 1564. No, nag-start yung expedition ni Legazpi in 1564 and then arrives first sa Cebu, no? And within the year, dumating muna siya doon sa Cebu and later on in 1572, no? Nahawak niya na rin ang Manila. Nahirapan siya that time, no? By history, nahirapan siya dahil may mga resistance sa Manila. Hindi siya nahirapan doon sa Cebu in 1565 and 7 years after sa kanya nakuha yung Manila, no? Dahil may mga resistance coming from our mga ninuno natin, no? Okay? So the name of the full name of Legazpi is Miguel Lopez de Legazpi, no? Miguel Lopez de Legazpi. Lopez de Legazpi. It can be Z or S. Continuing, so let's check the development. So instruction, the discussion of statistics had been carried over from senior high, no? So senior high school ninyo, therefore you may already have, no? Before we can go on further, please answer the table below by putting at least 5 items each, no? So, before kayo nag-college, ang statistics ay na-discuss na nung kayo ay sa senior high pa kayo. Okay? So, ilalagay, ililist down ninyo ano yung alam ninyo during ng senior high kayo. List at least 5. Okay? And then what I want to know sa statistics, since may idea na kayo dito, ha? So ano pa yung gusto ninyong malaman sa statistics? Ilagay nyo dito. And from there, what you have learned? So ano yung na-learn ninyo, no? Base dito. So alam ninyo at saka you know, base sa anong nakuha ninyo nung senior high kayo, ilalagay ninyo dito, including yung na-discuss natin, yung history, paano na-develop at the earliest civilization, yung statistics. Continuing, okay, after ng ito na, fill up nyo na, no, dapat i-fill up ninyo to, ha, sa module ninyo. And then, the study on statistics will not be possible without the people devoting their time on it, no? Some of them are listed below, no? There are 9, pero magdadagdag ako din ng isa sa isa sa mga prominenteng statistician din, no? Okay. So first, we are going to discuss about Gerolamo Cardano, no? An Italian mathematician, a physician, and a gambler. Okay? Who wrote Liber de Ludo Aliae, The Book of Chance and Games, which was considered as the first known study of the principles of probability. Okay? So, si Gerolamo Cardano, this was, he lives from 1501 to 1576. Okay? He is a mathematician, physician, so meaning kung din siya, no? Meron din siyang contribution sa medicine, okay, and a gambler. Take note that the Book of Chance and Games was published, this was published in 1663, no? Take note of this year that will come out sa quiz ninyo. Okay? So, ito yung unang tao nag-contribute sa statistics. The second person is under the name of Chevalier de Mere. Okay? Another gambler din, no? Ibig sabihin, malaking contribution din yung statistics, sa pagdevelop ng statistics dahil to sa mga gambler na ano, no? Yung hilig nila sa gambling, no? So Chevalier de Mere, he's actually a French, no? French nobleman and amateur mathematician in the 17th century, no? He's a French guy, no? Chevalier de Mere, who is a gambler, made a proposal to Blaise Pascal in the famous problem of points, okay? A work which marked the beginning of mathematics of probability. So, Chevalier de Mere lived during his life from 1607 to 1684. Okay, and he was the one again developed the theory of probability. Okay, the third guy is Lambert Adolphe Quetelet. He's a Belgian astronomer, no? Applied the theory of probability to anthropological measurements and expanded the same principle to the physiological, psychological, physical, and chemical fields. He established a central commission for statistics, which became a model for similar organizations in other countries, no? This guy lives from during 1796 to 1874. He is the one who made significant contribution in the field of social statistics, no? So important, contributed in social statistics and the concept of, siya rin ang nag-start sa concept ng average. The word average or the mean. Okay, so ito, this is the guy who initiated the concept of average and mean, or mean rather. Okay, let's continue. The fourth guy is Blaise Pascal, a French mathematician who invented a calculating machine, no? He also investigated mathematical theory of probability and differential calculus. So, Blaise Pascal is the guy. Was the guy. So, he lives during his life from 1623 to 1662. Okay. Blaise Pascal is also a physicist, no? He is considered as one of the great thinkers of the 17th century, no? One of the great thinkers of the 17th century. Si Blaise Pascal, no? The fifth one was Francis Galton, which he lived from 1822. And by the way pala, class, no? You notice Blaise Pascal, he only lives for until 39 years old lang siya. Pero ang dami niyang contribution na nagawa during his time regarding especially dito sa theory of probability. Okay, and yung subject sa math, no, yung sa engineering, sa differential calculus, it was Blaise Pascal who introduced it. Okay, so si Francis Galton, the fifth guy, he lives from 1822 to 1911. Okay, he is an English scientist, developed the use of percentiles. Okay, ito percentiles na encounter natin doon sa video. And the correlation method, and was an early proponent of statistical analysis as applied to mental and behavioral phenomena. Okay, that was Francis Galton. So next is Carl Pearson, a British applied mathematician and philosopher of science, was one of the major developers of the science of statistics. He originated the basic statistical concepts and procedures as standard deviation, si Carl Pearson yun, the random walk, and the chi-square tests. Okay. So notice Carl Pearson, he is known to be the one of the founding fathers of modern statistics. No, Carl Pearson is a statistician. Okay, like I said, he is one of the founding fathers of modern statistics. No, one of the founding fathers of statistics. No, so Tito, sa modern statistics in particular, he developed what we call the statistical theory and methodology. No, this is his contribution in statistics. No, yung statistical theory. Yun ang contribution niya. He lived from 1857 to 1936. 79 years old, no? Another contribution he made also, he is the one who founded the journal Biometrica. The journal Biometrica. Okay. So aside from that, yun nga no, yung meron siyang inintroduce or sa kanya yung nag-originate yung basic statistical concepts and procedures gaya ng standard deviation, random walk, and chi-square test. Remember yung chi-square test doon sa video, no? Ano ba yung chi-square test kung naalala ninyo? Ito yung to determine what? To determine the significance difference between observed and expected frequencies. Okay, yun yung chi-square test ang gamit niya, no? So si Carl Pearson, since from 1857 to 1936, no, nabuhay siya for 79 years, and in the on that process, mandami niya ring din na contribute sa statistics. On the number 7 guy, we have Ronald Aylmer Fisher, who is a British statistician and was the most prominent figure in the field of statistics in the 20th century, no? The most, no? By Ronald Fisher. He made many contributions from 1912 to 1962. Ito yung nag-start sa contribution sa statistics. Okay? But he was his lifetime started in 1890 to 1962, no? He was born in the year of 1890, 1962. 72 years old, no? Ang life span niya. So he made many contributions from that, no, 1912 to 1962, and has a great impact on contemporary statistical procedures. One of these is the Fisher test, the F test, used in the analysis of variance, which is having an acronym of ANOVA, in inferential statistics. Ano ba? You know, we will discuss that later on. No? Take note, analysis of variance was not discussed doon sa video. So, in inferential statistics, we will discuss that. Ano ba? Okay? Okay. So, continuing, since he was considered the most prominent figure in the field of statistics, he was known to be the father of modern statistics, no? Fisher, no? He was known as the father of modern statistics. See Fisher, no? So, Ronald Almer Fisher. Okay, so naging father of modern statistics siya. Fisher was known to be the father of modern statistics simply because he was considered one of the most influential statistician of the 20th century, no? So very influential siya nung during the time ng 20th century. Moving onwards by Asian Wall, he was the first to introduce the word statistics, no? Notice that Asian Wall lived from 1719 to 1772. Okay. The complete name of Asian Wall is Johann Gottfried Asienwald. Okay. So, continuing, Johann Gottfried Asienwald is one of the known pioneers, no? He's one of the known pioneers of modern statistics. I think Johann Gottfried is a German guy, no? Who lives in 1719 to 1772. Next is Zimmermann and Sinclair. Okay, are the ones who introduced and popularized the name statistics in their book, no? So, the complete name of Zimmermann, he was a doctor, no? E-A-W. His name is Dr. E-A-W Zimmermann. And Sinclair, his complete name is John Sinclair. Sir John Sinclair, no? So, sila yung they made it the word statistics, they made this statistics popular in their book. If you try to research about Zimmermann and Sinclair, the history of during their lifetime. Now, Dr. E.A.W. Zimmermann introduced statistics in England and popularized by John Sinclair through his work on And he is the one who made the statistical account of Scotland, no? So when we talk about the statistical account, no, itong si John Sinclair, ito siya mismo yung gumawa ng what we call yung statistical account ng Scotland. No? So, ito, ginagawa na rin natin, no, lahat ng country gumagawa ng mga statistical account for purpose of, yun, no, ipinag-aaralan nila yung population and anong dapat gawin sa mga population data. Okay? So, yun yung contribution nila sa statistics. Now, take note of the word statistics. Ito pa yung spelling ng statistics dati, no? This is an Italian word. Came from an Italian word, meaning from the word statista, no? Statista. This is an Italian word, which means a statesman. Okay? So, yun ang kuan ng meaning ng statista, no? Ang origin ng statistics came from the Italian word statista. Okay? So, I'd like to add na tao sa who contributed statistics also. So, number 10, ilagay ko na lang dito, ha? It was Carl Friedrich Gauss. Which contributed limited in statistics though, but na inintroduce niya yung method of least squares, no? Later known as statistical regression analysis, no? Yun yung ginagamit natin sa regression. Ang contribution niya dito ni Friedrich is more on astronomical observations for estimating orbits of celestial bodies, no? And making prediction about their movements. No? Prediction itself from the word prediction ng prediction of movements of celestial bodies is already involving statistics, no? Out of the prediction of its movement of the celestial bodies, which leads to calculate uncertainties and errors in observations, no? Which is what we call statistical techniques, no? In-apply niyo yung statistical techniques, yung prediction. Predictions, calculating uncertainties and errors in observation. Okay? Now, out of these 10 guys, you are now asked, eto na, no? Yung sa instruction, you are now asked to create your own timeline about the history of statistics as well as the people behind its development. No, people, instead of 9, gawin ninyo 10. No, dinagdagan ko ng isa si Carl Friedrich Gauss, no? Ngayon, gagawa kayo ng timeline tulad nito, no? Sino yung nauna? Kaya binigyan ko kayo ng mga years. So, pwede ninyong ilagay dito para alam niyo yung sequence. Sino yung nauna dito? Second, third, so on and so forth. Tingnan niyo yung timeline, no? To summarize the development of statistics based on these 10 people, based on this 10 tao na to. Okay? So, some part na hindi ko binigyan ng year will form part as part of your research. Kailan ipinanganak tong si Carl Friedrich Gauss? Alamin nyo as part of your research para mailatag ninyo dito sa timeline ng instruction, no? Which is the 10 people behind sa timeline, statistics rather. Okay? So, yun lang muna. Okay? I think, I almost forget. Let's practice independently. You need to answer also. Instruction. So, the instruction is to reason out in 5 sentences. 5 sentences. The usefulness and advantages of statistics in each of the following as provided. No? Sa education, ano ang importance or gamit or usefulness ng statistics sa education, sa management, sa economics, okay? And try also to check your understanding. Choose the correct answer in the list from the list in the box. Write your answer on the space provided for. You need to answer that also. Provide sino yung pinakauna nag-introduce sa salitang statistic, no? Naalala ninyo to? Yung Italian word from statista, no? Is an Italian mathematician who wrote the book of Chance and Games, considered the first known study of principles of probability. Sino siya? So answer this one also. 1 to 15. Okay? So that will be submitted the following meeting. Okay? So make sure to submit that answer sa in Microsoft Word form lang, no? Lagyan niyo na lang ng answer dito. Now class dito, paano niyo i-answer? I think kung yung answer niyo yung, let's say ilalagay niyo yung answer dito. Tingnan natin. Okay. Dito mapapansin niyo, punta lang kayo sa, kung mag-a-answer kayo, mag-i-insert lang kayo ng text box, most likely. Okay, punta lang kayo dito sa tab, no? Puntahan ninyo yung insert tab. And then, piliin ninyo dito yung text box. Para ma-answer ninyo dito sa baba, no? Ilagay nyo yung, paano nyo ilagay yung answer dito? Para hindi siya, kasi madi-disturb yung line na to. So what you will do is to use the text box. Lagay nyo yung text box. Okay? Pili nyo to. Ito yung gagamitin. Simple text box lang. No? So ito yung pipiliin ninyo. So text box. So ito, no? Gagamitin ninyo yung ito sa page na to. Okay. So what you will do is right click, wrap text, okay? So right click ninyo yung text box na yan, ilagay nyo lang sa, gamitin nyo yung wrap text and then inline with text. Okay, in line with text, tingnan natin. Right click, wrap text, in line with text. Okay. Oops, sorry. I think pwede in line with text, sorry, no? Ang gamitin natin yung isa, behind text. Okay, I think behind text para hindi siya apektado sa, ano, so, behind text, pwede nyo i-position ng maayos dito. Sino yung... Oops, sorry. Okay. Sa behind text, ito yung grab your reader's attention. Dali, ha? Okay, ganito na lang, no? Ang gagawin ninyo para i-answer is, una, gawin nyo insert text box. Okay, sa text box, ilagay nyo muna, let's say, Asian Wall, no? Or Johann Gottfried, sinong pangalan ni Asian Wall? If you can still recall, yung na-discuss natin kanina, Johann Gottfried, no? Johann Gottfried Asian Wall. Lagay natin, Johann Gottfried. Johann Gott, Johann double N, Gottfried G-O-T-T, Asian Wall. Actually, parang German ata to siya, no? Isa German guy. So after that, mapapansin ninyo, if you try to move, affected yung iba, di ba? So what you will do is to make it sa wrap text, right click, wrap text, and then behind text. Okay? So behind text, and then you can freely move that one and put it here, no? Ngayon, since malaki yung text, anong gagawin ninyo? I-highlight ninyo to. And then go to home. Liitan nyo yung letter. Okay, mga 9 lang. Okay, font size 9. Adjust ng konti. Okay. Okay. And then position nyo na dito. Okay. Ayan. Tanggalin natin tong X. Ayun, check mark. Okay, yan. Okay, that is how to answer. Then, ito pwede nyo pang liitan. Okay, then position dito. Okay, so may answer ka. So, you use text box para mas komportable to complete these answers from 1 to 15. Okay, so that will be all for now for this video. And that will take note that you have to submit this and answer this and submit it sa shared folder ninyo doon sa Google Drive. Okay, that will be all for now, class. Bye-bye.